everyone, welcome back to my channel. So as you can already tell from the title, today I'm bringing you guys a Lush haul and review. If you have watched my Get Ready for Valentine's Day vlog with Lush, you would have already seen like 95% of the products maybe. So if you haven't watched that yet, I'll leave the link down in the description box below so you can check it out later. So since I do have quite a number of items, I'm just going to jump right into the review. I'm going to kick things off with skincare products. The first item I got is a facial cleanser and it's called Angels on Bare Skin. So when you open it up, it looks like dry soil maybe, but this stuff contains some really good natural ingredients such as cleansing kaolin clay, ground almonds, lavender, rose and chamomile oils, and you can even see bits of the ingredients in the mix. With that said, this cleanser has a really mild, earthy and relaxing scent. To use, all you have to do is to scoop up a lump of the product and mix it together with some water to form it into a paste. It doesn't foam up, but it does give my skin a good and very gentle scrub, which I think is great for people with sensitive skin. Next up, I've got Ocean Salt, which is basically a face and body scrub. Having oily skin, I appreciate a good scrub, and this is definitely one. I actually got introduced to this product when I was given a tour at a Lush store, and I immediately fell in love with it. It's quite coarse, but at the same time, the mix is really smooth as well because it contains avocado butter. So I like that when I scrub my face, it also helps to moisturize it at the same time so it doesn't feel too dry or rough. If you have really dry skin, I probably wouldn't recommend you to use this all over your face, but I think it'll work great on either your body, your feet, or maybe just on your nose to remove any blackheads. As for me, I use it all over my face, and if I feel like it is exfoliating too much, I just add a little bit of water to reduce the friction. Next, I've got the very popular mask of Magnaminty. I've heard and seen a lot of hype about this one, so I really wanted to try it out for myself. It has a really strong peppermint scent from the peppermint oil, which I love as it feels really refreshing and cooling on my skin. This mask is supposed to be able to give your skin a deep cleanse, and I love that it contains some seed in the mix, so when I rinse it off, it actually gives my skin a good scrub as well. So the one I have is in self-preserving, so it contains a lot of honey to act as a natural preservative. Overall, I've been really liking this mask. After washing off, I do notice that my skin looks a lot clearer and fresher. The last skincare product is a toner, and this is the Aroma Water. This toner is pretty simple as it only contains rose water and lavender water. Both rose water and lavender water are very well known for its skincare benefits as it is used in many toners, especially in Korea. I love that this toner comes with a sprit nozzle so I can be more environmental friendly by not wasting any cotton pads. I am definitely enjoying this toner because I feel like it really helps to calm down my skin after a good scrub or after a facial, and it smells like lavender, which is one of my favorite scents. Before I move on to the hair and body products, I've got two oral care products. So the first one is the Boom Toothy Tabs that I got as a sample. The original packaging comes in a bottle that is recyclable, and this is to prevent wastage of the plastic tubes that toothpaste usually comes in. So Lush Toothy Tabs are basically toothpaste in the form of a tablet, and it comes in different flavors as well. The one I chose is called Boom because it has a really nice minty scent, and it also contains charcoal to help whiten my teeth. To use it, all you have to do is to chew on the tablet and then start brushing with a wet toothbrush. Initially, it does feel a little bit weird because I've never used a tablet toothpaste before, and it doesn't have that ultra minty feeling like regular toothpaste does, but once I rinsed it off, my mouth definitely felt a lot fresher and minty, and I feel like my teeth look a little bit whiter as well. Next is their lip scrub, and I got the Valentine's Day special called The Kiss. Prior to this, I have their lip scrub in the flavor Bubblegum, which I love, and it was a sweet cotton candy flavor. The Kiss smells quite similar to Bubblegum, but I have to say that I prefer this one because it has more of a raspberry scent and it is less sweet, and it also has tiny hearts in it, which I find really cute. Moving on to bath products, I received a gift set called All The Best, and it contains 4 bath products. The first product is a scrub, and it is called Rub Rub Rub. Other than using it on your body, you can also use it to wash your hair, and it can actually provide extra volume to your hair. Personally, I haven't tried that out yet because I do have quite a lot of hair already. But I've been using it as a body scrub, and one thing I noticed is that it doesn't melt in the shower unlike previous scrubs that I've used. It contains fine sea salt, lemon juice to help brighten your skin, as well as various floral scents. The next product is a shower gel, and it's called the Olive Branch. If you're into sweet or floral scents, this is not the shower gel for you. The shower gel contains mandarin oil, olive oil and orange flower, so in general it has more of a warm, earthy, citrusy scent. Personally, I'm not into floral scents, so I really like how calming this smells in the shower. It does foam up pretty well, and I like that it contains oil to help moisturize my skin while I shower. Moving on, we've got Rose Argan Body Conditioner, and this is the first time I'm using a body conditioner and I love it. You basically use it like a hair conditioner, except it is for your body. This one contains cocoa, shea, and kapuaku butters together with Brazil nut, almond, and argan oil. It smells absolutely amazing and it's so soft and smooth to apply. I highly recommend you to go down to a Lush store to try this one out. I also recommend this to anyone who has dry skin or if you're too lazy to apply body lotion after you shower. This is a great way to moisturize your body because you can put this on when you have your hair conditioner on as well. The last item in the gift set is the Honey I've Washed the Kids soap. This is one of Lush's best-selling soaps and it is also the only product I've yet to try. So I can't give you a good review of this soap, but I can tell you that it smells really good. It smells mostly like honey and I guess that's because honey is one of its main ingredients. Next, I've got a hair care product and this is the Jasmine and Henna Fluff Ease Hair Treatment. This stuff is packed with organic hemp, Brazil nut, and extra virgin coconut oil to help reduce frizz and moisturize your hair. It also contains red henna infusion to give your hair a nice shine. So this stuff has a really strong jasmine scent. So if jasmine is your thing, definitely check this one out. If you're not into jasmine scents, I would recommend you to go down to a Lush store and give it a sniff before purchasing it because it really does have a very, very strong jasmine scent. Personally, I'm not that into the scent, but I really like the result that it gave to my hair. We're on to the bath products, which I don't have with me right now because I've already used them, but I'll include some clips and footages of the products. First up, we've got Unicorn Horn, which is a bubble bar. From the internet, I found out that the best way to use a bubble bar is to crumble it into a sieve and let the water run through it. So that was the way I used my Unicorn Horn. I broke it into half and used it twice with two different bath bombs. Of course, I love the bubbles and I love how it transformed my boring looking bath into this pretty pastel pink shade. So the first bath bomb is the Loverland bath bomb, which is the bath bomb I used in my Get Ready for Valentine's Day vlog. It is a simple white bath bomb with red hearts all over it. It contains vanilla and cocoa butter, so you can just imagine how awesome it smells like. It's sweet but not too overpowering, and together with the unicorn horn, it was extremely relaxing and calming. After the bath bomb is done freezing, you can see red hearts folding all around your bath, which was so cute and appropriate for Valentine's Day. My second bath bomb is the frozen bath bomb, which contains mostly rose oils. So this one was a lot more pretty looking and magical because it is blue in color, so it just transformed my bath into different shades of blue. And it also contains shimmers, so it just made my entire bath look very blue, shimmery, and magical-ish. We're down to our very last two products and they are from Lush makeup range. Here I have two eyeshadows. For my Get Ready for Valentine's Day vlog, I featured a bright yellow shade that blends really naturally and pretty. I used it as a highlight for my eye makeup and I think it'll look great as an eyeshadow base or even as a blush as well. Intuitive is a lime green shade with shimmers. What I like about these eyeshadows is that they blend out really nicely, but at the same time they are really pigmented as well, so you can not only use them as eyeshadows but you can also use them as a blush or an eyeliner. Alright, so we're finally done with this Lush haul. If you'd like to see more Lush hauls or if you have any favorite products from Lush, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below and I'll see you very soon in my next one. Bye.